Hello students, welcome to zoology class. This is Akmal Hussain, lecturer biology, Square High School and College. Now I am going to take a biology class of standard 9, chapter 2. Today's topic is muscular tissue. Muscular tissue, the particular type of tissue capable of contracting and expanding of affect movement and tissue forming the muscles of vertebrate animals is called muscular tissue. That means we may say that the muscular part of our body is formed by muscular tissue. Matrix is nearly absent in muscular tissue. Muscle cells are delicate, elongated and fiber-like. It is originated from the mesoderm layer of embryo. Muscular tissue we may divide it into three. Number one, voluntary or stated muscular tissue. Number two, involuntary or smooth muscle. Number three, cardiac muscle. Muscular tissue, voluntary or stated muscular tissue. Characteristics of voluntary muscle. Number one, this tissue can be contracted or expanded at the will of the animal. That's why this kind of tissue is called voluntary tissue. The cells of the voluntary muscle tissue are tubular, unbranched and have transverse striation. This generally have more than one nucleus. It is also called marked or skeletal muscle. Follow the picture. At first we can see voluntary muscle, then involuntary muscle and finally cardiac muscle. Voluntary muscle, it is tubular, unbranched. The covering of this tissue is called sarcolemma, and the thin fiber-like structure which is available into the tissue or cell is called myofibril. Nucleus is present also, and the number of nucleus is most of the time more than one in each cell. And transverse deep-lined structure is shown here. This is called transverse striation. Involuntary or smooth muscle. Characteristics, number one, the contraction and expansion of this muscle tissue does not depend on the will of the animal. That's why it is called involuntary muscle. Number two, this muscle tissue is spindle shaped and faintly branched. Transverse striation are not present. This muscle is called unmarked or smooth muscle. Follow the picture. Involuntary muscle, I have told that it is faintly unbranched, most of the time unbranched. Nucleus is present, spindle shape. It is most of the time present in digestive system, respiratory system and blood vessels. That means artery, vein and capillary. Cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle is the special type of muscle which is present in the heart, or cardiac muscle is also called the special type of involuntary muscle. which helps to form our heart. Characteristics. Number one, the cells of this muscle tissue are tubular, branched and have transverse station. Between the cells of this tissue, intercalated discs are present. The contraction and relaxation of this tissue is not dependent on the will of the animal. The cells of heart muscle remain joined together by branches. Follow the picture. This type of tissues are branched, that means one cell connected with another. Intercalated discs are present, this is intercalated discs. Number of nucleus one most of the time for each cell present in our heart. Thank you.